Good morning friends, today we are going to discuss about the arithmetic progression. As we know that arithmetic progression is a series of numbers in which the common difference is same. What means we can say, let us take an example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Here you see, it is a series of numbers. Suppose you finish n numbers, having it is the first term, a 1, and here you see the common difference is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So this common difference is 1. This is called arithmetic progression. In this case, 1 is, this is called the first term, and these are the successive terms. Okay friends, so first term is represented by a. तो a इसको हम बोल सकते t1 is equal to a, t2 is equal to a plus b, term 3 a plus 2d, and like this tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is a arithmetic progression. Again speaking, arithmetic progression is a series of numbers in which each term, the difference between each term and two successive term is same. That's each called the common difference. The difference number is called common difference. Common difference that is d. Here in this case d is equal to 3 minus 2 is, or otherwise you can say 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So here d is 1. Here the first term is also 1. So it is a arithmetic progression. Having a series of numbers, 1 is the common difference and the first term is 1. And let us see. And friends, in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, each term, each one is called a term. Each one is called a term. Okay? Each number is called, in the series is called a term. And each term represented as t. So first term is called t1, second term is called t2, third is called t3, t4, t5, and like last term is called TN. As we have already talked that the first term T1 is equal to A, common difference D is equal to here, common difference is equal to D, and the last term is a plus a minus 1 into d. Okay friends, and each term is each term can be calculated by adding a plus b. So next term, so this is the first term, second term can be calculated as a plus d, third term can be calculated as a plus 2d, fourth term can be calculated as a plus 3d, and like in this way. Okay friends, some important formula, some basic formulas. Number one, in order to find the TN, nth term, we just calculate A plus N minus 1 into D. In order to find the sum of numbers SN, we just find N by 2, 2A plus A minus 1 sorry, a minus bar into d. So 2a a minus d. We can simplify this formula as 2a, we can write a plus n minus 1 into d. We see here a plus n minus 1 into a plus n minus into d is called tn. Means we can say this is the first term, or otherwise you can subtract it tn. This is called tn. So sum of numbers you can write n by 2 t1 plus tn. Okay friends, this is otherwise you can write or simplify it separately. So n equal to t1 plus tn by 2 t1 plus t. So this is the sum of numbers. This is the formula. You can simplify this or you can use this. Okay, so we got two formula here, n term and the sum of n terms. Okay, that's got to do some examples. Suppose a series is given 2, 5, 7, 9, 11. Yes. In this case, you are asked to find what is the 10th term. T10 is equal to what? Question will be asked, what is the 10th term in this case? So the number is, you say, again speaking, 2, 5, 7, 9, 11. So let us calculate the 10th term. See, before calculating, let us see the first term a is equal to 2, common difference a is equal to 5 minus 2 is equal to 3, a is equal to 10. This is the data given to us. Let us calculate. So tn, we know that a plus n minus 1 into e, this is the formula to find that nth term. Okay, but a here is 10, so we can put the formula. A is equal to 11 plus n is equal to 10 minus 1 into d. Into d is given 3. So see what is there? 2 plus 9 into 3. So 2 plus 27 is equal to 29. So that the 10th term is 29. Okay friends? In this way we can calculate any term from this series. Let us do some more examples. Suppose in another question, it will be given that the T4 is equal to 4 and T7 this is G. Let us take another example. Find an FP question. Find the FP whose second term is 30 and common difference is 3. In this case, what is given? Find the FP whose second term is 30 and common difference is 3. So friends, let us see. Second term is T2. We can write T2 is equal to A plus D. That means we can say 30 is equal to A plus D. D is not given. So T A plus D. a plus d. So a plus d, a is also not given, a common difference is given, 3, you can write, so you see 13 minus 3 is equal to a. So a when we say this is 10, the first term is 10, second term is 13. So the what is the ap? What is the ap? Let us find. Yeah, a you got a, d is given 3, so the ap is a plus b, a plus 2b, a plus 3b, like this. So a first term is 10, second term is 10 plus 3, third term is 10 plus 6, 10 plus 9. So what is coming? So 10, 30, 16 and 19. This is the ap. So what we are given, find the term, find the ap whose second term is 13 and the common difference is 3. Okay, let us do another example. Next question, find the ap, find the ap whose third term is 5, and the seventh term is 9, and the third term is 5. Let us see. Find the ap whose third term is 5 and the seventh term is 9. We are given t5, t3. So third term t3 is equal to 5. Another term t7 is equal to 9. So see, we know that t3 can be written as, we can write it t3 is equal to a plus 3 minus 1 into d, that is a plus 2d. Next, this can be written as t7 equal to a plus 7 minus 1 into d, that is a plus 6d. So this is one term and we got t7. Now let us calculate t7 a plus 6d t3 a plus 2d. Now subtract, this is 5, this is 9, to 4d minus 4d is equal to minus 4, that is d is equal to 4, by 4 is equal to 1, means the common difference we get 1. We got d is equal to 1, so d3 is equal to 5, that is a plus 2d equal to 5, that is a plus 2 into 1 is equal to 5, a is equal to 5 minus 2 is equal to 3, that is a is equal to 3. So the first term is 3 and the common difference is 1. So the ap is 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 1 5, 5 plus 1 6, 6 plus 1 7 and 9. So this is the answer. This is the series of the ap. Let us do some more examples. this another series is given that the LP is like this 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, like this. Then 5, the 20th term. Okay, friends, this is the series given 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, like this, and we have to find the 20th term. In this case, friends, a is equal to 3, we can see, and d is equal to 6 minus 3 is equal to 3, and a is equal to 20, so let us find t20 is equal to a plus 20 minus 1 into d, that is 3, a is equal to 3 plus 20 minus 1, 19, into d is here 3. That is 3 plus 57, that is 60. So the 20th term is equal to 60. This is the answer. Okay, friends, let us do more examples. Another question is given that sum of natural numbers, let's say 2, 5, 7, 9, 11, 12. This is another IP or series number series. So we have to find the sum of 20th term, that is S 20 is equal to 5. Sum of 20th term, that is S 20 is equal to 5. So let us find this solution. Here we are given that a is equal to 2, the first term is 2, common difference d is equal to 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. Okay, friends, let us find s. We are given here n is given 20, so s n, we know that n by 2 and a plus l, otherwise a plus l. So otherwise you can say 20 by 2 a plus, you can write this formula as 2a, 2 into a is what, 2 plus a minus 1 into d, a minus 1 into d here, a minus 1 into d 3. We are getting what? 10 into 4 plus 19 into 3. We are getting what? 10 into 4 plus this much, that is 10 into 61. So this is the answer. Okay. Let's just do one more example. Sum of 5. The sum of a natural numbers. Five, question is 5, the sum of a natural numbers. So we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the series is going to n. Here, the last term is n. So here you see, the faster a is equal to 1, b is here 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, so we have to find sl, n is equal to n, so sl is equal to n by 2, or in 2a plus n minus 1 into b. We can say n by 2 so 2a minus 1 into d 1. So what is coming? N by 2 2 plus n minus 1. That is, we can say n by 2 2 plus minus 1. 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So n plus 1. Can write this n into n plus 1 by 2. So Sn is equal to this n into only to n plus 1 by 2. Find the sum of twenty natural numbers. First 20 natural numbers, we can say first 20 natural numbers. So we can write this 1, 2, 3, 4. So last term is 20. Okay, friends. So see here. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 3 minus 2 is equal to 1, and N is equal to 20. So SN is equal to N into N plus 1 by 2. Now what happens? We can say N is 20, so 20 plus 1 by 2, that is 20 into 21 by 2, 2 tens are 20. So this is the sum of the first 20 natural numbers. Okay, friends. Just do another example. To find the sum of first 100 natural numbers. To find the sum of first 100 natural numbers, so we can say the series will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The last term is 100. So here we can write, friends, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, a is 100. Okay, so sn is equal to n, for n plus 1 by 2, that is 100 into 100 plus 1 is 101 by 2, 50 plus 5, 50. This is the sum of first 100 natural numbers. Next question. Yeah. Next question. Find the sum of first 200 natural numbers. First 20 natural, 200 natural numbers, sorry. So the series will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 200. This is the first term, this is the last term. So see, let us solve these questions. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2 minus 1. So n is equal to 100. So Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. That is S 200 is equal to 200 into 200 plus 1, 101 by 2. So this is coming 100. So 2 0 1 0 0. This is the sum of 200 natural numbers. Next variety of questions. Find the sum of 101 to 201. 101 to 200 numbers. So 101 to 200 numbers. So friend, here we can write the series will be what? The number starts from here. This is the series. You can find the. So in this case, what happens? You can write this series as well. 1. First, we have to find in this case what happens. We have to find 1 to 100. Sum of the numbers 1 to 100 minus 10. We are starting here from 101. That's why first calculate the sum of 1 to 200 numbers. After that, you just subtract it, sum of 1 to 100 numbers. Because we are starting from 101. So what we are going to do? First we have to find the sum of 1 to 200, then we have to subtract the sum of 1 to 100. I am going to do this one. Let us see what happens. To see the first series is that we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 200. Minus sum of 1, 2, 3, not 100. First, we are going to do here. First, find the sum of 200 numbers, then subtract from the sum of 100 numbers. So let us find in this case. A is here 1, B is equal to 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So A is equal to 200. So S 200 is equal to 200 into 201 by 2. Which is coming 100. So what is coming? This. Next come to this number. Here A is equal to 2. A is equal to 1. D is also 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. N is equal to 100. So S 100 is equal to 100 into 101 by 2. The 50 is coming to 5050. So this is sum of 200 numbers, sum of 100 numbers. We are going just to subtract to see 20100 minus 5050.